How do you get the same Zoom personal meeting ID every time? Well, maybe not every time, but very often anyway. It's a great question that I got on my YouTube channel. I'm starting using Zoom as a host with a basic account, great. And I want to have a standard, rarely changing meeting ID and password. So how do we do that? First of all, in Zoom, when you log into Zoom, and I'm into Zoom here, I've got what's called a personal meeting ID or PMI. And the idea here is that you're having meetings maybe with the same people each time, especially if you're starting in Zoom. Chances are you want to have the same account. You don't want to go through the rigmarole and the up and back and forth of, well, what's your meeting ID this time and what's the password and so on. So if you're having regularly scheduled meetings, you could use that personal meeting ID. Now, a couple of warnings here. One is, so this is on the Zoom help center. So I'll include a link to this in the description of this video. A couple of warnings here is that you don't really want to use it for back-to-back meetings. So a back-to-back meeting is, let's say you've got a meeting from 10 till 11, and then you've got another one from 11 till 12. And the reason you don't want to do that is that the 11 o'clock person may arrive sort of 5 minutes early, and maybe your 10 a.m. meeting is just running really close to the end time. And so your 11 o'clock person is going to turn up on the 10 o'clock meeting. And if that 10 a.m. meeting is a bit of a sensitive one, or maybe a job interview, or for whatever reason, you know, therapy, whatever it might be, they may not want to both be in on the same meeting, right? That's one reason you may not want to use the same meeting ID. And also with people who you don't meet with regularly. But certainly for my clients as a business coach, I have people who log in using the same personal meeting ID each time. So how do you do that? So we're logging into Zoom here. So when you log into Zoom, okay, so I've gone into Zoom, into the Zoom app, and I can go Zoom and then preferences and go straight to my profile and view the advanced features. As you can scroll down, here's the personal meeting ID. Here we go. Where are we? Okay, enable personal meeting ID. So this is a unique number that is assigned just to your account. It doesn't mean that every meeting has to use that ID, but you can do it in that way. It just makes it easier for you and for your participants to go back to that same meeting ID each time. So you need to make sure that that's turned on. You can toggle that's off, or I'm going to leave it turned on. Now, what about when you're scheduling a meeting? Do you want to use that? So that's in advance. If you are scheduling the meeting in advance, do you want to use that personal meeting ID? And yes, you can do that. And what about if you're doing a one-off meeting? Hey, let's just get started right now. Let's start a meeting right now. Do you still want to use that? You can change all of those settings. Now, do you want to set a password for your personal meeting ID? So this is a simple security thing, especially if you are making your Zoom meetings public. For example, you might be announcing it on YouTube or on a blog or on a social media. Hey, everybody, come to my meeting. If you are worried that sometimes people are going to hijack your meeting, somebody's going to come in just because they found your personal meeting ID, then this is a way of protecting you from that. Now, the other thing is that when you do send an invitation to somebody, it's going to have a link including the password. So they've just really got to click on the link. They don't have to remember all of the meeting ID numbers and so on. The other thing to note is that when people are calling in over a phone number, then they will need to type in the meeting ID and the password as well. Once again, personal meeting ID, you can set it in the preferences under Zoom, and I'm including a link to this instruction page. Depending on what kind of computer you're using and what browser you're using and all of that sort of stuff, it goes into some more technical details, which is beyond the scope of this video. So I hope that answers your question. You can enable that personal meeting ID, not for back-to-back meetings, and generally for meetings that you are doing with people regularly. It makes it easier for them and easier for you. Thank you so much for the question. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, then I invite you to subscribe to it, because I give some up-to-date information on how you can streamline your communications in your business and streamline your business itself and do it with confidence. Thanks for watching.